It's your boy Zappa, professional stage ninja, and welcome to farming? Perhaps. This is Factory Town, a game I've been interested in for a little while, and I finally decided to try to put my laptop to work on it. Hopefully this is recording well because, well, laptop is not the most powerful thing that I own, or that I have access to. I digress. Let's begin a new game with the default setting, because I'm just booting this up and only messing with settings. Welcome to Factory Town. At the start of each map, you'll have only a few workers. As you build houses, upgrade your base, and complete research, you'll soon have a fully automated network of conveyor belts and rail lines. Then unlock advanced magic power technology to achieve extreme optimization. Chutes are a handy way to transport goods long distance. Note that only some items, mostly natural resources, will roll down chutes. You also may need to rotate chutes pieces to ensure that rolled items travel in the correct direction when they reach an intersection. Conveyor belts are critical tools for automating your town. Place them on a building's front tile, and the resource will automatically be put on them and carried away. You can also directly feed resources into any other side or level from building start. If you have any items stuck on a chute you don't want, you can clear them out by using the pickup tool, J, and it'll be refunded to your share inventory. How many tips are these? Is this going to keep going? Let's see, everything you build, an upgrade will cost resource from your main player inventory. Everything in your base, as well as many items stored in barns, are included in this shared inventory. Markets will link houses that are nearby or that are connected via a network of footpaths and roads. These linked houses will provide bonuses to markets that help them sell faster. I think this is just goats. So I have a worker. To build and expand your town, you will need to collect tools and resources first. Start by gathering wood. Left click to select a worker, and right click on a tree. Okay, then right click on a tree, or a resource. Alright. Chop wood from the tree, bring it back to base, and repeat. Collect 15 wood. Use middle click to rotate the camera, or space. Oh, hi, you. Right click will rotate. Now, hopefully, this is capturing well, because at least on my side, it looks like it's a little jittery. And I did have problems last night with streaming and simultaneously recording World of Horror. Check a mark. Houses increase population, allowing you to create more workers. Open the build menu. Let's hit B. Buildings. Ye house. Also need to be near your base. Fine. Oh. Okay. Open build workers. Select workers. Select the worker. Place two workers in a house. Not traversable. Oh. Oh, it just said near your house. I got it. Coins necessary. I left click to select a worker. I need to get out of build. How do I get out of build? Oh. Escape. Got it. I'll right click on grain for the vegetables and right click. There we go. Cool. Okay. Hey, coins. Build a pass. Works much faster on pass. Open the build menu, pass, foot. Okay. Foot to pass. Extend this a bit. I didn't want that there, but whatever. We live here now. That's fine. Level mill turn more into plants. Planks which you need to build more shit. Gather 5 stone. Open the build menu. Do I have stone yet? Where are my resources? One stone. There we go. Okay. There we go. Does one scroll away? Wazzed. That's weird. I'll take it though. Have I a stone? I don't have enough stone yet. Let's actually do a home. Another home. So we can have another workman. Right. That was cool. I liked how it showed all my paths. No, I'm trying to change your thing. Excellent. Didn't I change your path? There we go. cool. Now we're just waiting on rocks. Gather five. Oh, I have 5 stone now. Duh. Go to buildings. Oh, but I spent all my dang wood. There it goes. Industry. Alright. Production requires spare population capacity. If you have already reached population limit, build more houses. Or delete workers. Rude. Okay, select lumber mill, select recipe, and select planks. Okay. Do another home. As soon as I have the resources. Time. Okay, cool. Now. Okay, select lumber mill. Press the select recipe button down here. And we planks. Alright. Job. Bring it here. All right. Do plank. Bring planks to lumber mill from the lumber mill to the base. Yes. Is that how that's going to go? Yeah. House can be upgraded further, increases population limit, select the house, hit upgrade. Once we have planks. Alright, your base can be upgraded to increase the house limit as well as your storage capacity. Select base, hit upgrade. Alright, so let's work ore. Alright. Okay, so your job. Do trees to mill. Your job is to deliver anything, everything. Okay. All right, so you're back on this now. Neat. I need dollars, more dollars. So let's build a new guy. Okay, your task is to engage tomatoes. Right click. Now, does that bring money? No. Okay, now. New buildings, new food farm, workshop. Alright, cool. Okay, we've upgraded bits. Excellent. This game's alright. Build a food market, so on. So, build a market close enough to a house that creates a connection. Okay. Buildings. Market. So then, where's my tomato guy? Okay, so grain. Grain here, and then my tomato man. Dang it, I did it again. Excellent. I built a grain mill. The grain mills turn flour can be sold for a higher price than is greedy for the goods. Okay. Find the flour, select the grain mill, select flour, bring enough grain to the grain mill to produce flour. Bring the flour to the house, the food market to sell it. Okay. So, hey, please scroll. Okay, so y'all continue. Now we do this. Right? Okay, you have new task. Okay. Huh. Okay, you're doing that. Y'all doing a bunch of... Uh-huh. Well, I think he's doing the work. Workshop lets you craft wood, wheels, conveyor belts, and help many of you to automate the town. Open build. Alright. What do you want? Workshop. Let's... Oh, I have not the resources yet. Oh, I need people. Home. No, I don't want to build. Okay, there. Buildings. Workshop. Okay. Left. Yeah, we're there. Okay, wagons can move forms at a time, but they cannot harvest it. Those movers faster than roads. Engage wagon. Bring the wood wheels to your base so they are in shared inventory. So I need to put a man to work. Ah. Hold on. So does it just start building wheels? Okay, workers. Okay, so select question, yeah, wheel. Oh, I get it. Well, there's that. But now I need... Right? Am I doing this right? Probably. I just gotta wait for that wheel. Okay, I've got a wheel now. I've got four wheels. Workers. Wagon. What if? Wait, okay. How do we do this? Okay. How do I engage the wagon, though? I'm not sure if I'm doing that right. This worker. Oh. Stone to wagon. Then wagon. Guess. Okay, shift can be used to roll certain entries directly into our outer building. Greatly speed up production because workers won't have to travel as far. Open buildings. Paths. No, path. A chute. So... left click and drag and draw a chute path into your lumber mill. Or grains. Can't afford to bring more resources to base or storage buildings. Okay, let's try this again. Path. Shoot. Can't afford bring more Oh, I can't afford the shoot itself. What do I need? Planks. time would my planks are going to the workshop. I have 23 wheels. Okay, there we go. Now I can do the thing. Maybe. Yeah? Place scaffold blocks and ramps to help place chutes over uneven terrain. Okay. Supply chute. Workers will be directed to deposit items in the chutes, natural resources, and grape wood, stone, rock, and pebble chutes. This may have been bad. But you know what? I'll figure this out next time. Maybe. Not quite into this, but I don't want to spend too long of my day stuck. I thank y'all for watching. And as always, SIEG ZEON.